Zoro and swords, possibly the greatest love story in One Piece. And whilst he has come to the position of many, it seems he still hasn't met the one made for him. Hello, my Nakamatachi, this is Joy Girl, and today we will be discussing our Straw Hat Swordsman in relation to his greatest love interest, swords. But before we begin, I do want to take a short time to urge you to subscribe to this channel if you haven't already, so that you can join our discussions of One Piece, which happens to be my greatest love interest, and I'm sure I'm not the only one who feels this way about the series, right? Anyways, back to today's discussion. Whilst there are other shonen sword fighting series, such as Rurouni Kenshin, Bleach, and Vagabond, amongst others, I have to say that when I think about swordsmen, Zoro is still the first to come to mind. One of the greatest aspects of One Piece is the diversity of unique fighting styles within the series. However, One Piece doesn't fail when it comes to portraying the beauty of swords and swordsmanship. In fact, One Piece contains its own range of exceptionally classified swords, known as the Mato. And let's quickly recap these graded swords in the series before we get to Zoro. The Mato grading system actually heavily resembles the Wazamono, a classification used in real-life Japan of exceptional historical blades. The Mato system contains the same four categories used in the Japanese system, which starts from Wazamono, the great swords, of which there are an unknown number of swords fitting into this category in One Piece, though in real life there are a total of 80. And whilst these are the lowest of the Mato blades, they are still far superior to normal blades as they possess exceptional resilience and strength. For example, Zoro's Sandai Kitetsu is one of the two known Wazamono grade swords, and we have witnessed its formidability firsthand. Nevertheless, outclassing this category is the Ryo Wazamono, 50 skillful grade swords of very high quality blades which yield exceptional strength, durability, and sharpness, as well as a light weight which allows its wielder faster speed. Of these, we have only seen or heard of three named blades, two of which are now in Taishiki's possession, the Kashu and the Yama Oroshi, and the third, Yubashiri, which is no longer in existence. Next, the O Wazamono. Known as the Great Grade Swords are 21 of the highest quality, as the second category in this system of exceptional blades. Out of all the sword grades, we have been introduced to more swords from this category than the others, all of which are currently in Wano. The Nidai Kitetsu, Wado Ichimonji, Shisui, Enma, and the Ameno Habakiri. The O Wazamono are known for their incredible power and an incredible balance of strength, sharpness, and durability. Indeed, these great grade swords are known to be able to stand up to the superior grade swords when in the hands of a capable swordsman. Speaking of which, the highest of the Mato is the Saijo O Wazamono. There are only 12 supreme grade swords, of which we have seen two, the first being Mihawk's Yoru, and the other being Whitebeard's Murakumogiri. And we also know of the Shodai Kitetsu, the first of the three cursed swords created by the Kitetsu swordsmith. And why is all of this relevant? Because our badass swordsman himself has previously or currently been in possession of five of the Mato. And this could be also illustrative of what swords he may come to wield in the not so distant future. Of the Wazamono, Zoro acquired the cursed blade, the Sandai Kitetsu, in Logtown, overcoming the blade's curse through his own luck and will. At the same time, he came into possession of the Yubashiri of the Ryo Wazamono class, which has since been laid to rest after being rusted away during the Enies Lobby arc. And of the O Wazamono, Zoro wielded Shisui for quite some time after acquiring it from Ryuma to replace his fallen sword Yubashiri, which he has recently traded in exchange for Enma of the same class. And also, he possessed another O Wazamono, the Wado Ichimonji, since the beginning of the series. This sword, which previously belonged to Kuina and her Shimotsuki family, is the only sword which has survived throughout all of Zoro's intense battles, a testament to its durability and strength. Whilst we have seen our swordsmen wield these various swords, we still have yet to witness the glory of Zoro possessing a sword that has been made with his abilities in mind. We could argue that out of all the swords he has owned so far, Enma may be his best fit. As Zoro specializes in armament haki, the distinctive trait of Enma in drawing out Ryo from its wielder makes Zoro an apt swordsman to handle this legendary sword. However, we could still say that even Enma wasn't made specifically for Zoro. The sword was formerly owned by Odin, who was the only one able to tame Enma. So whether we will experience the delight of Zoro coming into possession of a sword of his own is a question that often comes to mind. And if this was to happen, then I can't shake the feeling that there would be no better place for Zoro to acquire his own special sword than in Wano Kuni, the home of samurais and the home of many highly esteemed swordsmiths. Arguably, for Zoro to fulfill his dream of becoming the greatest swordsman in the world, it is necessary for him to acquire a sword fitting of this title. Furthermore, it seems even possible that Zoro will have a special sword specifically made for him in Wano, considering the history of esteemed swordsmanship of this country, and going further, Zoro's own personal relationships with the Shimotsukis. I have already discussed Zoro's relationship to the Shimotsuki family and the possible deeper significance of this in another video, which you are more than welcome to go watch after this discussion if you would like. But for the sake of this video, all you need to know is that Oda revealed in SBS 96 that the town in which Zoro grew up was founded by Shimotsuki Kozaburo, the highly esteemed blacksmith who forged Enma and the Wado Ichimonji. Considering this deeper relationship Zoro has to the history of Wano, it seems possible that this will come into play where we will witness Zoro receiving a sword that has been made for him specifically with his ability in mind. Tenguyama Hitetsu is an exceptional swordsmith who is hailed to be as skillful as Shimotsuki Kozaburo as the one who forged the Ame no Habakiri. Furthermore, Hitetsu once mentioned that he has been awaiting someone for a very long time. Perhaps an individual such as Zoro, as either possibly the descendant of the Shimotsuki clan, or someone just of his caliber when it comes to strength and swordsmanship. Perhaps Zoro is the individual that the swordsmith is waiting for. And once Hitetsu realizes that, perhaps he will forge a new sword for our Straw Hat swordsman. On the other hand, when it comes to the Kitetsu school of swordsmiths, it is known that each new generation of swords are weaker than those of their previous generations, implying that the skills of their ancestors are much greater. Which leads me to think that rather than a new sword being forged for Zoro, we will see Zoro attain a sword of his own. Not because it was specifically created for him, but because through his own strength and will, Zoro has tamed it and made it his own. In fact, I think it's possible that we will see this more than once. Zoro's current swords are the Wado Ichimonji, Sandai Kitetsu, and Enma, none of which come into the highest grade of Mato, the Saijo O Wazamono class. However, it was said that when a blade is turned permanently black, the sword may increase in rank, suggesting that it may move up a grade in the Mato system. For anime-only fans, we will be briefly discussing some manga-only content, so please do skip ahead to the time shown on the screen if you do wish to remain unspoiled. But for everyone else, we have recently seen that Zoro hasn't quite mastered his use of Enma yet. In chapter 1002, whilst he showcased his incredible might and strength in cleanly slicing off the horn of the Onigashima skull, this wasn't his original target, and the swordsman missed in damaging Kaido. With the legacy of Enma as one of the only swords to have been able to cut and wound Kaido, we are being set up to witness Zoro use this sword to achieve a similar feat. Perhaps it will be during his battle against Kaido that we will see Zoro tame the unruly sword. In which case, Zoro would come to master Enma and turn it into a permanent black blade, possibly raising its rank to the Saijo or Wazamono class. It's possible that Zoro will also be able to achieve this for the Wado Ichimonji. Whilst it has never been explicitly stated, it seems the Wado Ichimonji is also yet to transition into a black blade. If the Straw Hat swordsman is able to achieve this, then that will be two of the Shimotsuki Kozaburo swords which he has mastered and raised to the Saijo or Wazamono class. Which brings us to the third sword for the Suntory swordsman. Whilst Zoro currently holds the Sandai Kitetsu, it's possible that by the end of Wano, he will leave with either of its predecessors. We have seen that the Nidai Kitetsu is present at Wano, currently owned by Hitetsu, who forged Zoro's current Sandai Kitetsu. Witnessing Zoro's finesse and strength, and especially if Zoro is the man Hitetsu has been waiting for, the swordsmith may entrust his ancestor's superior sword to the swordsman in exchange for the return of his own creation, which the swordsmith seemingly forged as an imitation of the Nidai Kitetsu. Moreover, ever since Zoro laid his eyes on this sword, then in the possession of Luffy, the Straw Hat Swords enthusiast was very keen to get his hands on it. Annoyed at Luffy's incorrect use of the blade, Zoro was frustrated and very eager to take control. Which made me think that by the end of the arc, we will indeed see this happen. Or is it even possible that Zoro may come to possess the Shodai Kitetsu? As already one of the 12 Supreme Great Swords, this masterpiece is on par with Dracul Mihawk's Yoru and Whitebeard's Murakumogiri. Considering Zoro will one day have to challenge and defeat Mihawk for his title, it's only fitting that he has a sword of a caliber able to do so. Plus, Zoro being able to tame and overcome the curse of the strongest of the Kitetsu blades will be an awesome moment which would catapult him much closer to the title of the world's greatest swordsman. In saying that, we have little to zero information regarding the Shodai Kitetsu or as to its whereabouts, so it is hard to picture how Zoro will come to own this legendary sword. One possibility is that Hitetsu's famed katana, which he was also unwilling to lend Luffy, is the original Shodai Kitetsu. Although, considering that Hitetsu didn't wish to wield the Nidai Kitetsu due to its curse, it seems unlikely he would be currently wielding the more superior Shodai Kitetsu, which is likely more dangerous than the second generation blade. But that does bring us to the end of today's video. Please let me know whether you think Zoro will be attaining new swords in Wano, and if so, which ones you think he will acquire by leaving a comment below. If you enjoyed today's video, please like and share, and please subscribe and join us on our journey of discussing the expansive world of One Piece. This is Joy Girl, and I'll see you again soon.